Subscribe to our channel because it's free, and don't forget to press the bell icon for future updates. Hello everybody, today's video is all about holy basil care or tulsi care. So if you have got this plant at your home, do watch this video till the end. First thing you need to do with your plant is to check whether any weed growing by the side of the plant. If there is weed growing, remove it ASAP, because these take up essential nutrients from the soil which is required by the main plant, and you can use them in your compost bin for making organic compost. Second thing is to loosen up the soil firmly without damaging the roots. This needs to be done on weekly basis. This helps the air to pass through in soil well, thus making the roots stronger. Next is, you have to add organic compost every month to your soil to allow the plant to get proper nitrogen content. So you can always add a fertilizer which has great nitrogen content in it, because this is required for the vegetative or leafy growth of the plant. For making your plant bushier, you have to pinch off the main stem like this. When you pinch off the main stem, multiple stems come out from the sides, and you can repeat this process for 3 to 4 times again, and your plant will become bushier by doing this. Whenever you do the pinching process, you can use the leftover leaves in tea, because this adds great taste to tea. It is very easy to grow from seeds. You can see I have grown. Just make sure that you don't bury the seeds too deep. Whenever you burn the lamp, make sure it is away from the plant to ensure that it is not damaging the shoots as well as the leaves of the plant. Black aphids generally attack this plant, and if you don't take care of it, this will make the plant dead. Due to excessive watering, sometimes fungal infection may also occur in this plant. So I am going to tell you a remedy to treat these problems. For this solution, you need to take one part of the vinegar. Any home available vinegar can be used, be it apple cider vinegar or white vinegar. I am taking one part vinegar, 2 to 3 drops of mild soap, and 4 to 5 parts of water as compared to vinegar. I took 1 part vinegar and I am taking 5 parts of water. Spray it on all affected part of the plant, and you can spray it on the healthy plant also to make sure that it doesn't get the aphids attack on it. For the affected plant, you just need to repeat it after 2 to 3 days till you get rid of. Whenever you see seeds forming on the plant, just sniff them off, because when plant forms seeds, it utilizes a lot of nutrient and energy in seed formation process, and you can use these seeds in tea or food. Don't throw them away simply, because they have good medicinal properties. Adding Epsom salt and magnesium sulfate, 1/2 tablespoon in 12-inch pot every month, prevents magnesium deficiency in plant. Magnesium deficiency causes yellowing of leaves, so if you add Epsom salt, this will prevent yellowness of leaves and will make your plant happy. Do add water after applying this salt. Some few tips more I would like to share with you to make the plant healthy. This plant doesn't like overwatering, so make sure your soil is well draining, and whenever you water the plant, water as much required the plant only, not too much. Too much water addition will cause root rot and plant will die eventually. In Hindu religion, people add milk and water combination to plant. Adding excess of milk can cause fungal infections and make the plant dead. So prevent that from happening. Okay friends, bye. Thanks for watching the video. Stay connected.